Is there anything else in air? We see that what we would consider here is the major components of air. Is there anything else in air? Well, yes. There's always other minor components. Okay? So, most of the air we breathe is nitrogen. The next most amount is oxygen. Then maybe there's a little bit of water, maybe not, depending on how dry the air is. But then what else? And how much of everything else? Well, as it turns out, the way we define mixtures, well, excuse me, I'm going to tell you one more thing. Well, the other minor components, excuse me, I think I want to tell you something else, but I'm going to wait till the next slide. Some of the other minor components oftentimes are pollutants. I'll tell you that in a minute. But the point I want to make right now is that stating the concentrations of these various substances, pure substances, in a mixture is how we define the mixture, okay? So whereas pure substances are defined by their name, for example, a pure substance is oxygen. Oxygen is a pure substance, and then I define it by its name, oxygen. All right? But mixtures, air is the name of that gas mixture that we, live in our atmosphere, and the composition of it varies. So we have to define the mixture of air based on the concentrations of the substances that make up that air. Okay, that's why it's so important to comprehend this concept of concentration. All right, we use concentration units when we're describing a mixture. All right, we never use concentration units to describe a pure substance because a pure substance is pure. All right, so anytime you hear somebody describing some mixture, some bit of matter using concentration units, you know that that particular bit of matter that they're describing is a mixture. All right, so let me help this make sense out of this. All right.